friends, and welcome you all. So in the today class, we are going to solve the problems on analysis of beam using the fan. So on the screen you can see the question. So you need to determine the deflection and slope at 2 meter from the left end of the shaft mounted in a bearings. So these are the two ends where the bearings are mounted from the distance of 2 meter from left end. So this is the left end. So from here there is a 2 meter distance. So here some of the loads are applied. The loads are a load of 1 kilonewton and a moment of 2 kilonewton meter act on the shaft. So at a distance of 2 meter, the point load and the moment is acting. So point load, it will be 1 kilonewton, and where the moment, that will be 2 kilonewton meter. The bearings as fixed supports. Okay, so the bearings will be fixed support. So the question in the diagram, it will be given in the question. And also they have given the values of Young's modulus, that is the E value, 200 gigapascal, and moment of inertia I1 and I2. So for the element 1 and for element 2, it is given as 4 into 10 power of minus 6 meter power of 4, and I value is given as 2 into 10 power of minus 6 meter power of 4. Right. So at this point, you need to determine what will be the deflection at this end. Deflection and also the slope. Okay, vertical deflection and also the rotation slope. Okay, so now anyhow this is already in the discretized, you need to mention the elements 1. So the number of elements are 1 and 2. So two elements are there. So it is a beam element, and number of degree of freedom per node. So how many degree of freedom will be there? So at each node there will be, as we know, for the beam element 2 degree. One, it will be vertical deflection. Another, it will be a rotational. One, it will be a translation. Another, it will be rotational. So let us say here this will be as Q1 and this will be as Q2. Rotation it will be Q2. Like that we'll take at the node 2 also Q2 and also Q1, Q2 is completed. Now it will be Q3 and Q4. And at 3, vertical it will be Q5 and rotational it will be Q6. So these are the discretizing the element. So this is L1, this is L2, and E1, E2 it will be same, because the material property it will be same for the entire the shaft. Now you need to calculate whatever the stiffness matrix, element stiffness matrix for each element, like element 1 and 2. Okay, so the number of nodes are here 1, 2, 3, and elements are 2, and degree of freedoms 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these are the degree of freedom. Now we'll go to calculate the element stiffness matrix for element 1. So we'll say for element 1. Okay, so that will be where K1 will denote E1, I1. So E1 it will be 200 into giga. Giga value it will be, so first we'll convert, where Pascal is equal to Newton per meter square, then this giga value 10 power of 9. Okay, and unit it will be again Newton per meter square. So there will be no further conversion into 10 power of 9 Newton per meter square. Means all the values are in terms of meters. Length, it may be the Young's modulus, and moment of inertia, all are in meter. So EI value, that is 4 into 10 power of minus 6 by L cube. Okay, so L is the, for element 1, the length it will be 2. So it will be 2 cube. Again in the matrix, you will have 2L, 6L, next one. 12 and 6L. 6L is nothing but 2. So 6 into 2, again you will get 12. Right. So again 12, 6L minus 12, again 6L. So again it will be 12. So now 6L, so 12. Now 4L square. Okay, so L square, that is 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 2, 4L square, that is again 16. Okay, first, before that, it is better to make the stiffness matrix. Okay, the general stiffness matrix you write down, then you will not get the confusion. Okay, just I am substituting the L in the equation. Okay, so further it will be, okay, so you will get the this 4 into 4 stiffness matrix. Now after that you have to represent the degree of freedoms. So like here you will have q1, q2, q3, q4 for element 1. q1, q2, q3, q4 are the degree of freedom. Okay, similarly we will calculate for element 2 also. For K2, again Young's modulus, it will be same, 200 into 10 power of 9 into moment of inertia, that is 2 into 10 power of minus 6 by L. L is the length of the element 1, that is 1 cube. So 1 cube is what, 1 again. So now here it will be, if you substitute the L in the beam stiffness matrix, so it will be 2L. Now 6L, it means 6, so you can substitute the L in this equation. For L square minus 6, 2 minus 12 minus 6, 12 minus 6, 6, 2 minus 6, 4. Right, after substituting the L in the matrix, so you need to define the degree of freedom. So here for element 2, the degree of freedom, it will be q3, q4, q5, q6. So q3, q4, q5, q6. So this is q, okay. Now q3, q4, q5, q6. These are the degree of freedom. Now after that, you need to calculate the global stiffness matrix. Okay, the global stiffness matrix. So global stiffness matrix, adding the element 1 and 2. So that is K is equal to K1 plus K2. Right. So what we will get here from this equation? So just a minute. I mean, here you have to take the common term. So 200 into 10 power of 9 into 4 into 10 power of minus 6 by 2 power of 3, that is 8. So you will get 10 power of 5. Here you will get 10 power of 5. This one. Similarly, we will calculate for this one. 200 into 10 power of 9 into 2 into 10 power of minus 6. So we will get 4 into 10 power of 5. Okay, right. 4 into 10 power of 5 from this. Okay, now we will do one thing, we will take the 4 inside the matrix, then so that outside there will be 10 power of 5, right, that we can make here. So if you take 4 inside the matrix, so 12 into 4, I will make, better I will take, this is again K2 for the stiffness matrix, so 10 power of 5 for this continuation. I will take inside the matrix as 4. So 12 into 4, 48. 4 into 6, 24. 4, minus 48. Again 24, 48. 4 into 4, that is 16, minus 24, 8, minus 48, minus 24, 48, 24, 24, 8, 24, 16. So these are the, now again Q3, Q4, Q5, Q6, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let us say this is element 2, this is element 1. Okay, hope it is clear to you. Now we'll go for the global stiffness matrix. Here we'll make the global stiffness matrix, that is K is equal to. Okay, so anyhow 10 power of 5, it is same outside the matrix in both the element. So we'll take 10 power of 5. Now we'll make the global stiffness matrix. Okay, so it will be 6 into 6 matrix. So Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5, Q6. Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5, Q6. So Q1, Q1. So Q1, Q1, you will have 12. Q1, Q2, 12. Now Q1, Q3. So Q1, Q3 minus 12. Q1, Q4, 12 plus 12. And 1, 5, there is no relation. Q2, Q1. So 2, 1, that is again 12. Q2, Q2. So here at 2 also is not there. Q2, Q2, 16. Q2, Q3. 2, 3, minus 12. Q2, Q4, 8. 2, 5, 0, 0 again. Q1, 3, Q1, that is minus 12. Okay, we should take minus 12. Q3, Q2, Q3, Q2, minus 12 again. Q3, Q3, so Q3, Q3, 12, and also Q3, Q3, 48. So 12 plus 48, you will get 60. Right, again, Q3, Q4, Q3, Q4, minus 12, Q3, Q4, 24. So 24 minus 12, you will get again 12. Q3, Q5, Q3, Q5, minus 48, Q3, Q6, 24, now Q4 and Q1, 4 and 1, so Q4, 1, that is 12, Q4, Q2, Q4, Q2, 8, Q4, Q2, 8, Q4 and Q2. Next, Q4, Q3, Q4, Q3, minus 12, Q4, Q3, Q4, Q3, 48, minus 12, so 48, minus 12, Q3, that is 24, and minus 12, so you will get 12, plus 12 you will get here, right? Again, Q4, 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 16, Q4, Q4, 16 plus 16, so 16 plus 16, it will be 32. Now, Q4, Q5, so Q4 and Q5, sorry, here you have to observe, Q4, Q5, minus 24, Q4 and Q6, that is 8. Q5 and Q1, no relation here. So Q5, Q3. So Q5, Q3 minus 48. Right, now Q5, Q4 minus 24. Now Q5, 48 minus 24. Q1, Q6, 0, 0. Q6, Q3, 24. 8 minus 24, 16 is the value. Okay, so here there is a small mistake that you clearly observe. Okay, so this is a global stiffness matrix. So after the global stiffness matrix, So you need to go for the finite element equation, that is K U is equal to F. Okay, so anyhow, K you have calculated. Now this is the deflection vector and this is the force vector. Now what are the boundary conditions here? Okay, what are the boundary condition? It will be here. Here Q1 and Q2, it will be 0. Q1, Q2 and at the fixed end Q5, Q6, it will be 0. So all the four displacements are 0. Now the deflection at Q3 and Q4, that you need to calculate. So this will be the translational and this will be slope. Okay, deflection in the vertical and this will be slope, that you need to calculate. Okay, so anyhow, 196, 1, 2, 5, 6, that will be get 0. So now we can go with the elimination method so that we will get the remaining matrix. Okay, so first one, this entire row, it will get cancelled if you take 0, 0 and 0, 0. So this row it will get cancelled, second row, second column, fifth row, sixth row. Right, so what will be the remaining here? Remaining is 60, 12, 12, 32. This matrix you will get it. Okay, so now outside the matrix you will have 10 power of 5. Not 6, 10 power of 5. So what are the deflections here? So remaining deflection, it will be Q3, Q4 is equal to forces. So this is the translation, that is 1 kilonewton. So 1 kilonewton will take as that is acting downward, so we'll take as minus 1, and the slope, that is 2 kilonewton, so we'll take as plus 2, acting clockwise direction, because all the slope it will be taking the clockwise. So now here we'll make the equations like 60 into Q3 plus 12 Q4 is equal to minus 1 by 10 power of 5. So 1 by 10 power of 5. So you will get 1 into 10 power of minus 5. Okay, so this is the first equation. Second equation, 12 Q3 plus 32 Q4 is equal to plus 2 into 10 power of minus 5. These two equations you will get. Now in the calc you can directly substitute these two equations when you will go to the equations. Okay, so equation 1 you enter, then go to the unknowns are 2, A1 value is 60 and next B1 value is 12, C1 is minus 1 into 10 power of minus 5 and A2 value is plus 12, 32, next 2 into 10 power of minus 5. So this is the Q3 value, that is minus 1, 3 point, Q3 value is minus 3.15 into 10 power of minus 7. Yeah, minus 7. Okay, and another Q4 value, if you enter the equal, then 7.43 plus 7.43 into 10 power of minus 7 in meter. These two values are in, this one, first one it will be in the form of meter and second one it is slope, so it will be in the form of radian. So these are the values you will get it. Okay, so hope this value, this solution is clear to you. Have a good day. Thank you.